The drowning in the Sacramento River is another sad reminder of just how deadly Northern California rivers can be. Sacramento firefighters were called out to Sand Cove Park just after a man went under last night. That park is located just off the Garden Highway. It's near the I-80 bridge. Took the rescue teams about 2 hours to find the man's body. Firefighters say that the man, his wife, and his child were swimming in the river near a sandbar. The man slipped and drowned.
It's just a sad thing. They were out trying to have a good time. The beach here looks inviting. The beach is heavily used by a lot of people, but it can be very dangerous. Even if you know what you're doing, you shouldn't be in this water without a life jacket.
There are some signs posted at Sand Cove Park warning swimmers of the dangerous water conditions. The warnings include cold water temperatures, strong currents, and changing water levels. Recent summers have seen some pretty out of control partying along the American River, and now the Senate is getting ready to vote on whether or not to ban alcohol on the American River and its parks over the holidays. KCRA3's Chris Rivas is live along the American River now with more on that.
Well, good afternoon, Deirdre. To tell you where this ban would take place along the stretch of the American River, it's from here, the Sunrise Footbridge or Sunrise Avenue, all the way down to Gady Park. This has been the problem spots on the river the last 4 or 5 summers. Now, the ban would only impact Memorial Day, 4th of July, and then Labor Day weekends. And here's the problem. I can walk with a closed container straight from the banks out into the water. I can't have the beer on the banks because of city and county laws, but state laws allow you to drink on the river. So the ban would ban all alcohol at all times on those holidays. These are the images of the American River that we've shown countless times over the last 5 years. This stretch of river is from Sunrise Boulevard to Gady Park. And during the summer holidays, they turn into drunken stupors with fights and lots of arrests. These are the images of who this impacts. Susan Haight and Peggy Fong were not rafting the American River last July 4th. Their kids were. Susan's son Brian and Peggy's daughter Kendall were passengers in this car when their designated driver was driving home drunk from the American River. They were killed instantly.
The grief has been, he's our only child, and it's been too hard to bear. My husband and I live day to day, just trying to get through each day.
Susan and Peggy say the tragedy has made them the best of friends. They've joined together to fight to get alcohol banned on the American River during the summer holidays.
When I read about this bill, I said, you always hear people trying to save one life. No, this will save hundreds of lives.
The main issue here is the fact that that drinking was allowed on the American River, and you will not only have adult drinkers, but you will have underage drinkers using this waterway as an excuse to drink, where they will not be detected.
Well, this is exactly what we're talking about. The ban, if it goes into effect later today, would be against the law coming 4th of July this holiday weekend. Now, Fitz, I should say they're voting on this today, and the way that the language is written into the bill is that as soon as Governor Schwarzenegger would sign it, the law would go into effect, which means this 4th of July they could get the ban if passed in the Senate today. Reporting live from along the American River, I'm Chris Riva. Deirdre, back to you.
Good grief. It looks like they need to get it in there this afternoon.
Exactly. And it's funny. I was just making a comment to Kurt Fuller, a photographer. We've seen about 15 rafts so far. Mm-hmm. All have alcohol on board. No life jackets. It just doesn't make sense to me.
I know, but they always seem to go hand in hand. Thanks, Chris.